Programming languages are the basic means that people can communicate to computers. My job is twofold. Number one, I'm trying to take an existing language and then translate that language into something that a computer actually can execute. And the other aspect is, well, if you have new problems, you might actually need new languages, right? So we have to design new languages, we have to come up with new abstractions, and then, of course, also implement these new abstractions in translators. So our idea is to basically, first of all, come up with new programming abstractions to use phones, plus to optimize for power consumption. So we had developed now a new spatial notion in the programming language where you can actually can talk about services that are available on such a dynamic network. One driver application, we call this, these are applications that showcase the potential of this new architecture, is what we call Amber Alert, right? So Amber Alert is actually a system that tries to track down abducted children. So now how could we use these dynamic networks of cell phones to do this? And the answer is you might want to go out there and for a specific search area, let's assume it's a part of a town, and then ask, well, can you please take a picture, or is there a camera out there that sees a red car or a red sedan? And once that picture is taken, this might actually be then sent to a specific piece of software that's able to analyze this image and then says, okay, yes, there's an interesting car at that intersection. And that information in turn could be shared with other people around this intersection, or of course with the authorities. Initially, we start with Java, and then just the thinking of, well, we need to be able to talk about space. That was the initial start. So we actually have now an infrastructure where we send programs into that network, and it might jump from one cell phone to the next cell phone, does its thing, and then comes back. The gliders, as you see here, they are commercial products, so you can buy them. However, it turns out that they are right now very hard to program for oceanographers. The first insight was that the current programming model was very hard to understand. So we came up with a clean slate approach. In order to do this, we had to develop the language, and we actually had to also put in a new board into the existing system. And the design challenge was that we didn't want to throw out the existing infrastructure, but instead kind of tag on our new infrastructure so that users who are a little bit afraid of our infrastructure can use the old one or slowly migrate to the new infrastructure. I have a small group of undergrads whose only job it is basically to sit down and thinking about, well, if I have iPhone, if I have Nokias, these kind of machines or phones, what to do with it. And they came up with some interesting applications. Seems to be that students are very concerned with getting home on time, so there's the bus application where they're kind of trying to find out where specific buses are, how busy the bus stops are, and so on and so forth. One aspect of all this, particularly with the programming language, I can envision that we can build a very limited program language, meaning a language that lets you say only very simple things that are very safe to do. And this might be a tool to give to probably not elementary school kids, but middle school kids, so that they can actually write their missions and we could go ahead and execute them without being worried that they actually lose our equipment. So basically it's an enabling technology to bring science into things like middle school or high school and get people excited about it and hopefully get more interest in people taking kind of math and physics and biology.